Welcome to today's session. In this class, we'll continue timer operation with a corresponding few more examples related to generation of a different frequency time sequence. Okay, that is different time delay will be generated here. Let us take a program to generate a square wave from the port P1.5. Means the square wave will be continuously generated from the port 1. That is from the 6th bit. Okay. Now, here we are using a timer 1 to generate a delay for a square wave. And a mentioned a crystal frequency, it will be 11.0592 megahertz. And the very important step is that we are not considered any overhead due to instructions of the loop. Okay. This is what the statement of the example. Let us take with the program. Okay. Now, as in the program, it is mentioned timer 1 means we are using the higher nibble of a TMOD register. So, when I say TMOD register, the higher nibbles, okay, let us take these are the higher nibbles, 4 bits. Okay. Now, mode 1, mode in the sense 1, 0, 0, 0. As we know that mode 1 will be the lower 2 bits will be indicating mode. The next will be CT and the gate. Okay. Now I am using internal clock. So, 0. Okay. That's a count for the time interval generation 0 and gate because it will be software controlled. Okay. Now here randomly I took a value with a TL1 and TH1. I hope you can understand I am using a timer 1. Okay. Now if the timer 1 is that, we have to use a TL1 and TH1. That's why you need to read the given statement clearly, which timer you are using and which timer we have to configure. Okay. Now, TL1 is loaded with 34, TH1 is loaded with 76. Okay. That is lower byte and a higher byte. Now, we have to start the timer by using SETB instruction. Okay. This is the standard step. Okay, change the sequence and all this. You have to go with the sequence wise how it is given here. Okay, now once a set P will be a timer is started, we are monitoring the TF1, okay, until it will set. Okay, so if it is not set, it will be keep on looping in the same instruction. Means looping in the system means our timer will be getting incremented from what value? 76 3F. Okay, it will be keep on incrementing. How long it will be increment? It will increment up to maximum FFF. Once it reaches FFF, when it is rolling back, again the TF1 will be set here. Okay, I hope you can see TF1 will be set. For timer 0, TF0. For timer 1, TF1. Separate bit will be mentioned for the each timer. Okay, now once the TF1 is set, okay, we have to stop the timer by using clear TR1, okay, that is a TR1 will be set here, and complement P1 point means I need to be clear the timer, okay, and whatever the bit value, okay, let us check from the port P1.5, if it is 1, we will complement to 0, okay, that is what the P1.5, again it will be jump back, again when I say jump back again, it will go to the line TL1, TH1, again this process will be repeated, means I am getting a delay, okay, from the timer for this one, okay, for high value, for the low value, means whatever the time period I require for my program for the square wave from the timer 1, it is generated by the timer. Okay, I hope this will be clear. Okay, now since I'll calculate how much the delay will be generated here, okay, by hexadecimal value, or you can see if you are good enough with the decimal also, you can do it, not an issue. Okay, now what is the maximum value as you are given here for 16 bit? FFF minus 7634. I hope you can remember this. 7634 is not the decimal, it is a hexadecimal. Okay, subtract this. Okay, after subtraction, you'll come with like a 89CBH plus 1. Okay, otherwise you can do FFF minus 7634 plus 1. Both will be fine. So you'll end up with like a number 89CCH. Okay. Now, when you convert this 89CCH, okay, you'll get with a decimal value because I need to multiply. Okay, if you are trying to multiply with a hexadecimal, okay, with a value number, you may not, your calculator or your calculator won't support. Okay, that's why 35276. Okay, into 1.085. I hope you understand why I took a 1.085. Okay, simple. I'll just repeat for a minute. Okay, 12 divided by 11.0592 megahertz. So it will become up with the 1.085. So what you get here, 38.274 millisecond for half the square wave. Okay, I hope you can understand for half square wave, that is for the period of half. Okay, because this will be loop, this will be looping it for positive as well as for negative, means for high as well as low. Okay, if it is asked for like a full square wave, you just add it one more or multiply by two. Okay, also note that, and the frequency, there is a frequency will be like, if you just invert it, you may get with the 13.064 hertz. Also noted that high portion and low portion of square wave pulses are equal. Okay, means because I am not changing here anything. Okay, in further class also, we can see how we can change it. Okay, only thing that the same steps steps will be given, but we have to change with the TL1 and TH1. Okay. Let us move to the next content. Okay, how to find the loaded timer values. Okay, in this program, okay, now previously I took a randomly with a TL value and TH value. Now if it is asked what is the value I have to load, what is the value for the TLX and THX I have to load, that we have to find. Okay, this, the value has to be found from the given statement or a desired time interval. Okay, I hope this will be clear. Okay, let us see with the steps. Okay, how we will calculate. To calculate the values to be loaded into TL and TH register, okay, these are the four standard steps. You need to remember this. It is not actually remember and all this. If you well versed with us, a few examples, automatically you can able to do it. Okay, let us assume that crystal frequency is given as 11.0592 megahertz. Okay, sometime if it is asked with a different frequency, you assume that frequency. If it is 20 megahertz, 10 megahertz, you substitute with the crystal frequency 10 megahertz. Now we can use the following steps for finding TH and TL register values. Okay, the very important is that the very first step, divide the desired time delay by 1.085 microsecond. Okay, means whatever the frequency you require, whatever the time delay you require. Okay, let us take that I require X delay. Okay, I require X time interval. Okay, that is X millisecond divided by 1.085 micro. Okay, that's simple here. Means X will be, it is actually you require that time interval. Okay. Now, I hope this will be clear. Okay. Now, second step. Now, you after the division of this one, you'll end up with the sum number. Okay, that's that number. Okay, now perform six in the second step. Perform 65536 minus n, where n is the decimal value we got in step one. Okay, I hope this will be clear for you to know. Means after division of the previous step, now that value will be substituted in n with the subtract with the 65536, because you know why 65536. Because it is a F value, there is a maximum 16-bit value, 65536. It's a standard, you don't change it. Okay, now after the subtraction, you will come with the one number. That number is in decimal format. Okay, now convert the result of step 2 to hex value, where YYXX is the initial hex value to be loaded into the timer register. Whatever the value you get, that need to be loaded into the TL and TH register. I hope this is very simple, very clear. Okay, now where this XX will go? Now the XX will be loaded. This XX will be loaded into TLX. That is, the lower byte will be loaded into TLX. and higher byte will be loaded into THX. Simple as that. Okay, I hope this concept will be clear for you. Okay, let us move with the example. Okay, while taking in the previous steps, I hope the previous steps are very clear for you. Assume that crystal frequency will be given 11.0592 megahertz. Okay, it's a standard. Okay, standard in this is sometime. Okay, you can change it. If it is with the 20 megahertz, okay, you make with the 12 divided by 20 megahertz, and you can able to calculate this. What value do we need to load the timer registers if we want to have a time delay of 5 milliseconds? Means how much delay you require here? 5 milliseconds. And what value we have to load? That we have to find it. Okay. Now 5 milliseconds, that is in millisecond. Show the program for timer 0. Now I am using timer 0 to create a pulse width of 5 milliseconds from which port? From port 2.3. Okay. Now the what the main objective of the program is that we have to find the TL and TH. And once you get here, from which port? P2.3. There is a port 2. And what is the frequency is mentioned? 11.0592 megahertz frequency. You need to be observe carefully what are the things will be given in the example, and which timer you are using. Timer 0 means I have to use a T mode. Which bits will be configured? There is a lower nibble will be configured. Which mode? Mode 1, because I'm using it in mode 1. I hope it is not mentioned here mode 1. Okay, you consider by default as mode 1. Sometime in exam also you mention is mode 1. Okay, that will be good, because anyway it is for 16 bit, you take it with mode 1 only. Okay, crystal frequency. The counter counts up every 1.085 microsecond. I hope you understand from how you get a 1.085 microsecond. I'll repeat. Okay, 12 divided by 11.0592 microsecond. Okay, 1.085 microsecond. This means that out of many 1.085 microsecond interval, we must take 5 millisecond value pulse. Okay, now simple as that. Okay, now what is the required frequency time delay? It's 5 millisecond. Means I have to divide 5 millisecond divided by 1.085 microsecond. Okay, that is what I did here. Okay, that's a 5 millisecond divided by 1.085 microsecond. Now you will end up with a 4608. 4608 is a decimal value. Okay, now what this is this is what the first step I have calculated. In the second step, what we have to do? You have to subtract this value with the 65536. Okay, 65536 minus 4608. Okay, now whatever the value you get, okay, this will be okay. Now if I get here 65536, okay, now after subtraction of this 65536, 4608, you will end up with a value, okay, that is in decimal only. Okay, it is not a subtraction is done, subtraction operation is in hexadecimal. Okay, now for you to get here, I got here 60928 after subtraction of this. You convert this into hexadecimal. Okay, you will come with the EE00. I hope you get the value. Now EE00, W will be loaded into TH, double zero will be loaded into TL0. Okay, I hope you can see this in the program. Okay, the steps will be repeated here. Clear 2.3, because you need to be see that in the statement what is given here, because 2.3 is a port. Clear 2.3. okay, if it is high, low to high, whatever is the value. Okay, clear it. Okay, move TMOD 01. As we know, we are using timer 0 with a mode 1 operation. TL0, okay, now TL000 both will be same. TH0 will be loaded with EE. Set B, timer will be started. Set B TR0, timer started. P2.3 okay, I'm setting with a 2.3, means it will be start with a high. Okay, you can use it. Okay, complementary in the next one, you can change it, not an issue. Set B means what? Now it will be start with high. Where high? Port 2, 3. High will be there. Set B. Okay, timer will be started. Okay, it will be keep on looping it. How long it will loop? Until TF0 will be set. Once it is set here, it will come out from the loop, clear the timer, stop the timer. Okay, again it will be looping it. When you go here, okay, when you go for the clear here, again this will be looping it. Or looping it for a generation of the pulse. Okay, I hope this program will be clear, because there's a simple operation, as quiet as possible. Okay, now let us move to the one more example. Okay, assume that the crystal frequency will be 11.092 megahertz. Write a program to generate a square wave of square wave. Now it is called as a square wave. Square wave, this is equal square wave of how much here? 2 kilohertz. Okay, 2 kilohertz square wave. This is similar to the previous example, how we are given here. Okay, what is the frequency is mentioned here? 1 divided, that is, frequency will be calculated, given it's 2 kilohertz. Okay, the time interval will be 500 microsecond. Okay, that is, we know that t equal to 1 by f. We will get here 500 microsecond. Okay, half of this one. Okay, because it's a full cycle. What are the 2 kilohertz is given for the full square wave? Okay, full square wave. Okay, means I have to calculate first for the half cycle now. Okay, so that's why how much it is divided by the 250 microsecond. Okay, because 250 microsecond, as we know from the previous statement, 250 divided by 1.085. Okay, now we will get with the 230. Okay, 230. 230, there is a 65536 minus 230 decimal value. You will get with a 65306 is a decimal value again. You convert into hexadecimal value from your calculator, you will get with a FF1AH. Means what will be loaded into TL? 1A. What will be loaded into TH? FF. Okay. Now this is a program how we are given. Okay. Now this will be generating TH with FF. TL with 1A for how much time interval? For 250 microsecond. For 250 microsecond it will be on, 250 microsecond it will be off. Means I need to get the delay. Okay. Now T mode will be configured for mode 1, 16 bit TL. What we have obtained from the example, we have to load it. Set B, timer will be started. And we keep on monitoring. I hope these steps will be repeated here. Okay, now which pin we are getting here? P1.5. Okay, P1.5, clear it. Clear the TF1, jump again. So that again it will be keep on looping it. Okay, now I hope this program will be clear for you. So that we can able to calculate. Set P, TR1, start timer. Okay, looping it, clear TR1, clear P1.5 and clear TF1. Jump here again, it will be jump to the specific again instruction, so that again you will get early end up with like a square wave. Let us take with the one more example. Okay, now I hope you can do it by yourself. Okay, that is, what is the frequency will be given? 50 kilohertz. Okay, square wave, half of this will be like something like 25 kilohertz. Now you'll get with 20 millisecond for full square wave. Half of this will be 20 millisecond, 10 millisecond of this one. So 10 divided by 1.085 microsecond, you'll come with like a 56320. You convert that 56320. Okay. You'll get with a DC00H and load that 00 into TL, and TH will be loaded with DC, and repeat the process. I hope this program will be clear. The program steps are similar. There is no change in the steps of the program. Only there, how much the requirement of a time delay you need to calculate. Okay, because 20 millisecond, okay, half of that. You need to be clearly read the statement, whether the square wave, okay, how much will it be now, okay. You can see this half of the bit, okay, high and low portion for the pulse, okay, like this. Now, okay, let us move to the one more example. Examine the following program and find the time delay in seconds. Exclude the overhead due to the instruction in the loop. Okay, overhead due to the instruction, we will overcome this. Okay, now I have to calculate. Okay, I need not. Okay, now we are using timer 1, mode 1. Okay, that's why 10, 10H. Okay, now I'll move to the solution part. Okay, what is the value of TL1 and TH1? Will be 10, that is 0108. Okay, when I convert it into decimal, it will be come up with the 264. 264 is the decimal value. Okay, as we have discussed in the previous class, that is a 65536 minus 264 means how many clocks I'll get here? 65272. Okay, 655272 into 1.085 microsecond, you will come up with like a 70.82 millisecond. And for 200 of them, okay, we have 200 into 70.820 millisecond. Okay, because for 200, okay, because I took it, okay, this I'll come to this one. 200 for this one, that will be 14.164024 seconds. Okay, there's a very interesting thing is that R3 will be given. Okay, this internal loop, internal loop will be repeated for how many times? 200 times. Means what is the one clock pulse, one time interval? 70.80 millisecond means it will be multiplied by 200. If I say, okay, if this will be repeated, for 200 times, this one, okay, from here 200 times. That's why DJ NZ R3 means internal program will be repeated for 200 times. The internal one will be creating a time interval of 70.20. If I change it to something like this one for 100, okay, means the internal program is repeated for 100 times. Means totally I'll get with 100 into given time sequence will be 70.82 millisecond. Means I may get with something like 700.82 millisecond. Okay, so if I convert here, you may get with a different time interval. Okay, I hope this program will be clear here. Okay, for you to know, okay, let us take with the first step here. 10H, repeat, 10H, configure the timer. R3 will be loaded with the 200, it is a decimal value, 200. TL1, TH1, okay, it will be, okay, it is a standard, it is a fixed value. I took it here, it is not mentioned with the time delay. Now, timer will be started. You keep on monitor the TF1 bit. Okay, jump on no bit and loop it in the sequence. Clear TR1, clear TF1, decrement. Okay, once here come to the line, decrement, jump on no zero, R3. R3 will be decremented by what value? 200 minus 1, 199 decimal value. It is not zero. Go to again load it. Again, means the internal, the loop, okay, internal setup program will be looping for 200 times. And internal clock, okay, internal timer will be 70.82 millisecond. So multiply this. Okay, I hope you can try with some more example. We'll see in the further class. Thank you.